poor Junior. He worked all weekend, but he headlined. Great job,
Rich
Junior.
Man. Yeah.
Thank you. Uh-huh. Subject, my best friend married my ex-husband. Dear Stephen Shirley, I don't know where to begin. I'm so hurt and overwhelmed by the chain of events that have happened to me. In 2007, I got married to the man of my dreams, or so I thought. We were divorced in 2009. The divorce was emotionally and physically draining for me. I had a very close friend I confided in about the process and some of the things that happened during my marriage that led to my divorce. She was like a sister to me, and I considered her to be one of my best friends. Earlier this year, things changed between us, and I began to feel that she was pulling away from me. We wouldn't talk as much, and when we did, she was very dry and brash. One night, she told me that my ex-husband asked her for my phone number because he wanted to talk to me. He called and apologized to me, and he even called and apologized to my mom. He insinuated that he wanted to try to work things out and possibly get back together. He said that he still loved me and he had butterflies when he heard my voice. I didn't want to go there again because he had hurt me so badly that it took me over 3 years to get over him. I accepted his apology and that was that. A few months later, my close friend tells me she and my ex-husband have feelings for each other. I was very hurt that she would betray me. A few months after that, I learned that they were married. How could she do such a thing? I'm not hurt and upset because of him, but because she was supposed to be my friend. I know that time heals all wounds, but this hurt runs deep. Sincerely devastated. And I'm devastated right with you. I really am. I know you're still hurting. And I know she hurt you. Because betrayal, especially when it's someone this close to you, someone you've confided in, someone that you thought was your friend, it's some unexplainable kind of pain. Your so-called friend broke that girlfriend rule that we have, and we all girlfriends know what it is, and that means we don't date or we don't marry our girlfriend's men. We don't do that. It's not okay. We don't do it. Even if you might have feelings, anything, you don't cross that line. You just don't do it. And a friend, a real friend, wouldn't do that. But here is the issue, and I got to tell you this. The issue is you, okay? This is the issue. What's done is done. You cannot let this define your life anymore. I know you're hurt by it, but the rest of your life cannot be defined by this. Yes, you're right, time does heal all wounds, but if you could find it in your heart, we talk about this a lot on this show, to forgive her. If you can find it in your heart to forgive her, I know. That's when, I know. You got to search deep. You got to try. You have to. Because that's really when you can start to heal and move on with your life. I mean, I know it's going to take some time, but just try it. She's really pretty stank, though, this so-called girlfriend. I will give you that. Steve?
Well, I have a different opinion here. All right, I'll give you mine when I come. Surely everything you said was correct.
Yeah, we'll be back. You're listening to what she's doing, sharing his life.
Yeah. Well, here's his letter. My best friend married my ex-husband. We ain't got to go through this whole letter. Let's just go on and get to it.
Pulled out the wrong card.
In 2007, I got married to the man of my dream, or so I thought. We were divorced in 2009. Got married. And 2 years later, exactly, it was on and over at the same time. So it was a two-year dream. Wasn't even a two-year dream, because it takes time to get divorced. So the man of your dreams became the nightmare of your life. Well. You confided in a friend of yours. You say she was like a sister to me, and I considered her to be one of my best friends. Then things start changing between y'all. Then one night she told me that your ex-husband asked her for my phone number because he wanted to talk to me. He called and apologized to me. He even called and apologized to my mom. He insinuated he wanted to try to work things out and possibly get back together. He said that he still loved me and he had butterflies when he heard my voice. I didn't want to go there again because he had hurt me so bad. It took me over 3 years to get over him. Okay, now. This is a dude, lady. Let me forewarn you. Here's a guy that says to women, what they want to hear.
There
are some guys that would tell you whatever it is you want to hear. Gave the apology. He called your mom and apologized. You know, I'm not saying he ain't sincere about it, but he know what to say, when to say it, and how to say it. Well, a few months later, your close friend told you she and your ex-husband have feelings for each other. Once again, saying to another woman what she wanted to hear. But let me tell you how he sucked her in. Then you find out they got married. See, you got to be careful who you tell your business to. Because she took all that info and then showed all the opposites to him. Because that's what women do. Now, I would have never done you that. She didn't believe in you. I would always believe in my man. Ladies, y'all know women do that all the time. Showed all the opposites. Presented her case. He's stupid. He fell for it. But then the real trick on her is she now gonna inherit the trash you had.
Woo.
See, you gotta look at that side of it too.
Mm-hmm.
See, good riddance. Cause now she gonna see what you, it only took you 2 years to find it out. Not even two. She got to find out the same thing unless homeboy done changed, but it don't look like he changed.
You're listening to the Steve Harvey Morning Show.
Stop walking around. Yeah. Well, when there's love.